It was known as Noah's Ark, the four-story wood frame house located at Daniel and Panhello Streets was home to Reverend Noah Parker in the 1760s. It survived three major fires, but succumbed to urban renewal in 1965, torn down for a parking lot.
We wanted to create a design that would make people wonder about what happened here. And then they start to begin to learn about Noah Parker and the maritime history of Portsmouth, which influenced the architecture of the site.
Architect Tracy Kozak explains the three-story steel and wood building is a nod to Portsmouth's shipbuilding past.
We used heavy timber construction in the vertical timbers and in the curved vessels and in the interior finishes. And the way that we joined these timbers together is similar to how the boat builders would build the gundalows on the Piscataqua River.
Inside this bright and bustling emporium, the Hearth Market. There are cozy corners and couches for small groups or large tables for communal dining. You can settle in by the fire or take a table in the new street-side bistro for full-service traditional dining. And right in the center is the market. And as for food, it's as diverse as the space.
The Hearth Market was created to create an environment where we have collaboration, community, and food that would be shared amongst your friends.
CEO Rob Azunian believes the different selections of cuisine suits all tastes.
We have our pizza realm where we can cook fresh pizzas. We also have the Hearth Market, the center, where we also have presented food that we can either take home or you can heat that up and serve it at lunch or dinner.
The Elixir Bar offers a variety of craft cocktails and mocktails, which are becoming more popular post-January. This beverage is called Starry Night.
In this case, we have pineapple, orange juice, ginger, lemon, and turmeric, activated by some black pepper. We shake it up and add a little aquafaba, which is the juice from chickpeas, to give it some depth and a little bit of a texture.
Good for you, and it tastes great. If deciding on a drink seems like a tough choice, when it comes to food, well, you could come to the Hearth Market dozens of times and never order the same dish.
We want to be a place where people can come and they can fill their bellies here if they want. They can really explore and indulge their senses here while they're visiting, or they can take something home and have it, you know, in their fridge or bring it home to heat up and enjoy later. So it's very much equal parts a restaurant and a market. So you can explore and indulge in the capacity that works best for you.
If you're craving a slice, head over to the pizza oven for a hot pie fresh from the oven. There's margarita, pepperoni, vegan supreme, just to name a few. Looking for coffee and dessert? No shortage of baked goods to conquer your cravings at the cafe. Speaking of sweets, over in the street side bistro, there are even more selections. Plus, you can pull up a stool and build your own crepe with all kinds of toppings, including Nutella and fruit. Plenty of vegan options as well.
I'm a vegan myself, so I always love talking about the vegan offerings that we have. We have an array of plant-based items in our center. We've got local fish. We have some wonderful soups.
At Hearth Market, the artwork is as creative as the food. Right now, the exhibit is comprised of artists of the seacoast, sculptures, paintings. The space is about local art as much as it is about cuisine. Artist Thomas Berger gets his inspiration from nature. He uses natural stone in his sculptures. This 11-foot piece stands in the front entrance. Adorned with sea life, this was custom made for the hearth.
The starfish are all different.
Yes, they're all individually made and also a little different in size and movement.
Outside on the back patio, which is filled with customers during the warmer months, Thomas's passion for nature is carved in these sculptures, caterpillar and butterfly.
where you have an opening with gold leaf in. When the sun shines through, it glows out of there. And that's what happens even at this weather a little bit, but especially when the sun shines on the wings, it just starts glowing.
There's also hidden art throughout the space. Look closely at the large stone fireplace. Can you spot how it pays homage to the Granite State?
There are medallions in the floor if you follow. The restaurant is laid out to be a meandering path, a journey through a food experience, and you will find these symbols of community and goodwill throughout if you look closely at the details.
There is retail, specialty items and gifts. Hearth plans to add ice cream just in time for warmer months.
Kind of in that trattoria atmosphere of the Italians. They want to bring all their friends in, they want to gather, they want to have wine, they want to have a vast variety of food on the table. And Hearth was built in the sense of having community gatherings.